Hello everyone and welcome to this second Remixlive finger drumming tutorial. Today we will see everything you need to know about our new finger drumming grid and on how to create original patterns. The difference between track and pattern recording is that in the first case you record the master output with everything that you play, whereas with a pattern recording you can record your own loops playing notes and percussions on the finger drumming grid. Now that we've made things clearer, let's do this. So, here we are on the main screen with the loop grid. And, as seen previously, here's the grid selector. Tap on drum to land on the finger drumming grid. The grid is divided into two parts. The left side is dedicated to drums and percussions, and the right side is dedicated to notes and melodic instruments. Present on both grids, the Quantize button for the finger drumming grid is there to make sure that you always play on the beat, as it snaps all your hits to the closest beat depending on the chosen Quantize value. For instance, choose 1 and each hit will be played on the next beat. Choose 1 quarter and each hit will be played on the next quarter of beat. It is also a perfect fit for devices suffering from latency. Where Remixlive has really evolved is in its capacity of becoming a full-fledged instrument. An experienced musician can express his creativity entirely by finger drumming live using all the elements of the grid. Finger drumming is a discipline in itself, and it's not always easy for everyone to play different things at the same time, and this is where the pattern recording comes into play. This tape recorder enables you to record your own patterns using the finger drumming grid to create original patterns. Tapping on it opens a sidebar displaying pattern recording options and lets you select a pad on which you will record. There are two methods to select a pad to record a pattern on it. Either you are already on the finger drumming grid and all you have to do is to tap on a tape recorder. It will automatically select the last played pad of the loop grid. Or you are on the loop grid and all you have to do is to tap on the tape recorder and it will automatically select the last played pad of the loop grid and jump to the finger drumming grid. If you want to record over another pad, go back to the loop grid and tap on a pad to select it. Before recording, make sure you set the pattern length. Tap on the pattern length box to choose a pattern length, 1 beat, 2 beats, 4, 8, etc. Once recorded, you cannot change a pattern's length. Now that you're all set, turn the metronome on and tap on the rec button to start recording your pattern. You can build your pattern bar after bar as it never stops recording unless you tap back on it. Play a drum beat, add percussions, add a bass, a synth melody, and so on until you're done and happy with your pattern. Because we're human, mistakes can happen, and you might play something wrong, miss a beat, or just not like what you did. In case you need it, you can tap on the backward arrow to undo recorded events at any time. Please note that you can only undo events during the pattern recording and that you can only undo the events of the last recorded bar. Once you're done recording, tap on the rec button to stop it. And here's your recorded pattern. Tap on it to play it or to turn it off. Something else you might want to do is to record over a pattern without deleting it. For that, simply select a pattern pad and turn on the overdub for recording. Once you're satisfied with your loop, but still hear some mistakes such as early or late hits, you can use the replay Quantize, which, just like the Quantize we saw before, snaps all your hits to the closest beat mark, depending on the value you have chosen, but this time it works for a pattern. For that, go to the sample editor, select your recorded pattern on the loop grid, tap on replay Quantize, and choose a value. Now, your recorded patterns appear as gray pads on the loop grid where you can replay them, and are all automatically stored in the user subsection of your sample collection. And that's all for today, folks. Coming soon, we'll take a closer look at the advanced sample editor. I look forward to seeing you soon with a new Remixlive finger drumming tutorial.